Good morning, my dear students, and a very warm welcome to all of you in this e-learning program. We are doing chapter number 4, which is structure of atom. Try to recall whatever part we have done up till now. First, in the beginning, we did about the whole concept of atomic structure. If you will read the textbook, you will read the Dalton's postulate, but Dalton's postulate in detail will be done in chapter number 3. So, right now we are concerned with the core part of the chapter. Let us first have a quick look at the whole of the lesson and some of the very important definitions which we have not yet discussed, that we will discuss. Very simple and short theories, little bit are left out. So, we'll first have a look at that. First of all, welcome to science. By Harsha ma'am. Friends, in our today's session, let's have first a quick recap. Try to recall what we did in the structure of atom. When we discussed the structure of atom, we discussed that an atom is circular in shape. We see, we can just say like this, it is. And at its center, we are having what? Nucleus. In the nucleus, there are two things. One is proton and neutron. Number of proton and number of neutron are varying depending on the atom you are selecting, and the electrons are moving around the nucleus. While moving, they are radiating energy, and the various things are getting carried out. About that also we have studied when we studied about the different models of the atom. Electrons are moving in this energy levels. This is called as orbit or the energy level. Then you are having about the contribution in atomic theory. If we talk about this concept of the contribution of a person in atomic theory, then they have discussed about few of the scientists. Okay, and in that we are having first about the John Dalton. This is the whole theory part. He was born in a poor weaver family in England. Then he became the teacher and then the principal in the school. And then he discovered the law of expansion of gases on heating, which you are going to study in your higher standards if you opt for science stream. This theory no one is going to ask you, but yet it's just for information. Then he invented the dew point hygrometer. He found the various methods of finding out the partial pressure, and he explained the various other laws, and he suggested that the atmosphere also contained the magnetic constituent, and calculated atomic weight of many elements. So this is his contribution in the atomic theory. Then if we talk about Sir G.J. Thompson, he gave the plum pudding model, which didn't work out. And then for his theoretical and experimental investigations, he was also awarded the Nobel Prize. We already know about his fact that he discovered the electrons. Then comes Ernest Rutherford. He was the one who did the alpha ray scattering experiment, and he was awarded also the Nobel Prize for it. And he was born in the New Zealand, and he was among the 12 children of a farmer. Then with very difficulty he studied. Then James Chadwick, about him we are going to like his contribution we are going to do today, that is the discovery of neutron. How he gave the concept that about the neutrons, that we are going to see today. He was one of the most brilliant students of Rutherford. and he made fundamental discovery of neutron that we are going to discuss today. He was also able to calculate the mass of the neutron, and he was also awarded the Nobel Prize. Then comes Niels Bohr. He made a great contribution in understanding the whole of the structure regarding the arrangement of the electrons. And his primary work was on atoms. And he was one of the witness of the atomic explosion in New Mexico. And he was also awarded the prize for atom for peace. So this is all about the basic theory part, which is there included, and you just have to read it. You don't have to mug up anything, because none of the things is going to come in your exams. But the basic thing is you should know about these people. They have given a lot to us in terms of knowledge, if we speak. Cleared many concepts related to atoms. So as far as atomic theory is concerned, these are the pioneers of the atomic theory. So little bit amount of their lifestyle and what they were doing and the parents were doing is given. It's just for your knowledge. It's not important as far as examination point of view we are talking about. Then comes the charged particles in matter, and that you are having about here the lesson actually starts with, that is the discovery of electron. If we talk about the discovery of electron, then how was electron invented? So for that, it was Sir J.J. Thomson and William Crookes who worked a lot regarding this, and they gave the whole of the concept and of the electron. For that, what they took is, they took an electric discharge tube, and then to its both the ends, the electrodes were kept, and vacuum was created inside it, and high amount of voltage was given to it. Then it was observed that the rays passed from negative terminal of the battery towards the positive terminal, and that is from cathode to anode, and this is how cathode rays came into existence. This is how it happened. Very simple and very easy concept. About 10 kilovolt of voltage was given, and if this is anode, this is cathode, then it was observed that all the electrons were going from cathode to anode. Okay, so this is what was observed. Then comes the next thing, that is the properties of cathode. What actually the cathode rays are and how their properties we can talk about. If we talk about the properties of the cathode rays, then in between of the cathode rays, if any object is kept, suppose over here, then we will be able to see its shadow over here. In the path of the cathode rays, if we keep anything, then its shadow is, we will be able to see its shadow on the other end. This shows that they travel in the straight line. Next, if we put a mechanical fan over here, then what will happen? The fan will rotate. Once the fan will rotate, what can we say? We can say that it is producing mechanical effect because it is moving. The next is, it is negatively charged. How can we say now these rays are negatively charged? Yes, we can say that also. Suppose if we are creating the positive charge over here and the negative, in this way we are creating the external field, then what will happen? All the electrons will migrate towards the positive pole of the battery. So this is how we can say that they are negatively charged, because they got attracted towards the positive pole of the battery. And this is how we can say that electrons are negatively charged. Next is how the electrons are emitted. The very first one is, on any metal, if heat is supplied, then in that case the electrons will get emitted from the atoms. Next is, when on highly reactive metals like potassium, sodium, if ultraviolet rays is passed, then in that case also the electrons are emitted. Next is, action of all the X-rays on types of matter. Now you might be thinking, what is an X-ray? X-ray also, the concept is very simple. Formation of X-ray from this was very simple. A metallic plate was kept over here, and in between, if you keep anything, then its image gets fault on this. And this is the whole concept. Whenever any particular metallic substance is kept in between, then the properties of that particular cathode rays changes, and this is how X-rays were formed. And Röntgen was the one, R-O-N-T-G-E-N, who gave the whole of the concept. Next is, all the radioactive substances like uranium, thorium, polonium, they emit beta particles, that is, they emit electrons. So these are the ways the electrons are emitted. Coming to the next part, which is the characteristics of electron. If we talk about the characteristics of electron, then its mass is 9 into 10 raised to minus 28 gram. If we talk about its mass with respect to hydrogen atom, that means proton, then as compared to proton, it is 1840 times smaller. Then measuring E by M ratio, that is electric charge upon mass ratio, this whole concept was given by one of the concept by Millikan's oil drop experiment. He was the one who made us understand about how we can calculate the charge of electron. Yes, the charge of electron, which is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb, negative of it, that is the charge on electron, and he had calculated it. Yes, try to recall, we have already done this concept. Then coming to the next part, which is the discovery of protons. Like this concept only, the discovery of proton also took place. Now, what was different in the discovery of electron and the discovery of proton? Here, small gases were also, in very small proportion, the gases were also kept. And the pressure was very low, which was about 0.001 mm of mercury column. And the cathode ray was perforated. Now, when the beam of electrons, when it came over here, when it passed through any of the atom, it lost the electron. Okay, so whenever any atom is losing the electron, it will become positively charged, and this positive charge will get migrate towards the, from anode, it will go directly towards the cathode. So in this direction, all the positive ions will move. Okay, and we can see the red glow behind the cathode. So this is how the whole experiment of discovery of protons took place. What is the effect of low pressure now in this? The low pressure is taken, that is resulting into the formation of the rays, because at high pressure, the electrons will collide, and they will not allow the atoms to get converted into ions. Next is properties of anode rays. They will also travel in the straight line, as we have discussed. They produce mechanical effect, that means if you have putting a mechanical paddle in between, then it will constantly move. Why? Because this rays are producing the mechanical effect. Next is, they are positively charged. How can we come to know that they are positively charged? Just like we did right now for electrons, arrange the electric field. If it is migrating towards a negative terminal, that means that it is a positively charged. The nature of anode rays, it depends upon the gas which is taken into the discharge tube, because on the basis of the gas, E by M ratio is defined. And it is very important to note that E by M ratio is highest for hydrogen. And next is the characteristics of the proton. If we talk about the characteristics of proton, then proton is having the mass of 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 24 gram. It is about 1837 times heavier than electron. And the charge on the proton is plus 1 and unit charge. And its value is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Next was the plum pudding model that was given by Sir J.J. Thompson. The next part is Thompson's model. Now, what was there in this Thompson's model? He took he just tried to say that we can compare the atom with a watermelon. Yes, he did a normal comparison of an atom with a watermelon. Now, what he actually did was, he said that we can consider the red edible part as the proton and the black seeds as electron. And this is how he made the comparison and he gave the concept of the structure of the atom. But this had few drawbacks. He said that it is, if it is like atom was like that, then how can positive and negative charge together? They will combine with each other because of the force of the attraction. And this is how the whole of the concept of given by Sir J.J. Thompson proved to be wrong. Then came Rutherford's model, that is the discovery of nucleus. Rutherford's model, if we talk about it, then in the Rutherford's model, he took one gold foil. And he a very thin gold foil of about 0.0004 mm, and then he allowed alpha rays. Alpha rays are positively charged helium nuclei rays. He allowed those rays to fall on the thin, very thin gold foil, and he was shocked. He saw that almost all the rays went straight away and 1 out of 12,000 rebounded back. Yes, this was the thing that he observed, and he couldn't digest this. Yes, these were the things that he couldn't digest. Next is his explanation. Why the rays passed straight away? The rays passed straight away because, and if we talk about an atom, then atom is containing a nucleus in the center. But overall, it is hollow from inside. Because it is hollow, almost all the rays pass straight away. Then 1 out of 12,000, it rebounded back, because that particular at the center, it is having the positive charge like the nucleus. He gave the following conclusions: that nucleus is positively charged, it is very dense and hard, and it is very small as compared to the size of the atom. The difference in the size of the atom and that of the nucleus is of about 10 raised to minus 10. That is the difference in their sizes. And the whole mass of the atom is concentrated at the center of the atom. Coming to the next particular part, which is the drawbacks of Rutherford. Now, what Rutherford said was correct. Like, the electrons are moving, and then Maxwell, he gave the other, like he said that one question regarding this Rutherford's model, which we completed right now. This is the line of action which we did. Coming to the Rutherford's model, if we talk about the Rutherford's model, then in this model we have discussed that regarding the drawbacks. Maxwell said that if any negative thing is moving around the positive thing, then as per his theory, if anything is moving around any other thing and both of them are having opposite charges, then the one which is moving will lose all its energy and go and merge with the oppositely charged ion. Then why it is not happening in the case of electrons? Electrons are constantly moving around the nucleus which is positively charged. Then why it is not happening like that? Okay, electrons are going and merging and mixing with the nucleus. Why? Rutherford was not able to explain. So this is considered as the drawback. Another drawback of Rutherford model was the inability to explain the relationship between the atomic number and the atomic mass. At that time, neutrons were not discovered, but later when the Chadwick discovered about the neutrons, the fact was clear. Then comes Niels Bohr's model. He gave the concept or the postulates like this. In the Niels Bohr's model, he said that all the electrons are arranged around the atom in a circular pattern and they are following some particular fashion. That is, they are arranged in a particular pattern. And that's the reason they are not going and merging up. Whenever an electron is going from one energy level to another energy level, it is radiating some amount of energy, and that energy is given by the formula is equals to HF, where H is the Planck's constant, whose value is 6.6 × 10⁻³⁴ joule per second. With this, the concepts of atomic theory was clear. Now, coming to the today's concept regarding the discovery of electrons, regarding the discovery of neutrons, how were neutrons discovered? Yes. First of all, the person who gave the whole of the concept regarding the discovery of neutron, it was in 1920 when William Draper Hurkins, he explained about why the mass of the nucleus is coming double. Okay, how the neutrons were discovered. Important point: discovery of neutron, today's important topic. If we talk about the discovery of neutron, then what is neutron and how its existence came? First of all, we know that any atom, its atomic mass is number of protons plus number of neutrons. Now, when they were measuring the weight of the atom at that time, neutrons were not discovered. So when they were measuring the weight, they are knowing only about proton and electron. Okay, neutron to picture bhi nahi aaya hai. Unko kiske baare mein pata hai? Only about proton and electron. They are knowing about only these two people, these two things. So when they were measuring the weight, as compared to protons, it always came double. So they were worried. Why it is like that? Okay, and coming to the charge, if suppose the protons are double in number, then why the electrons are not getting more attracted? That was because neutron has no charge, and The prediction about it was given in 1920 by William Draper Harkins. In 1932, it was Sir James Chadwick who gave the whole of the concept. Now, how he did this? One of the very important experiment he carried out. He first imparted highly moving alpha particles on beryllium. Yes, beryllium, count hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium. With atomic number 4, you are having beryllium. It is having the atomic mass of 9. On that, fastly moving helium nuclei was allowed to bombard. Once he bombarded, he saw that there is some particle which is having mass as same as proton, but it is having no charge. Some of the very important properties which he saw regarding the radiations that were emitted on imparting alpha rays. Okay, what did Sir James Chadwick did? And what were the properties of this radiations? This radiations were highly penetrating. Okay, बहुत penetrating means वो घुस जाते हैं. So they are their moving speed and everything is very much high. Next very important thing he saw was they did not got deflected by any of the electric field or magnetic field. By no field it got attracted. That means it is having no charge. This is the very important point. This depicts that it has no charge. The next thing is the particles that were making the radiation, their mass was equal to the mass of proton, and because they are electrically neutral they are called as neutron, and its mass came up to be 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. Okay, Let us have a quick look again regarding the discovery of neutron, one of the major part of our today's content, that is the discovery of neutron. It was Sir James Chadwick what he did was he imparted quickly moving helium nuclei on the beryllium, and then he observed that one neutron he constantly did, and he saw the radiations getting emitted. With this he predicted that there is something here, and then what he did was he observed the radiations and he carried out different tests. With this he said that they are highly penetrating. Next is they are not affected by any of the magnetic or electric field. This is very important and the major part. That means it is no charge. And mass also came up to be 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 24 gram. You have to memorize this particular equation. That is 94 Be plus 42 He gives 12 6 carbon plus 1 neutron. Okay, so one of the major part over here is of it. So please note down regarding this discovery of neutrons, and after you complete noting down this, then we will discuss little bit further regarding this concept. Okay, please move note down this quickly and then we'll move further. So I hope you have noted down regarding this discovery. And I hope you are clear also how the electrons were discovered. It's very, very simple. What did Sir James Chadwick did? He imparted quickly moving alpha particles on the beryllium, and the neutrons radiation was observed. Moving to the next concept, which is the model of the atom. So all these people finally explained regarding the model of the atom. That is, at the center we are having nucleus, which is containing protons and neutrons, and the electrons, they are moving around it. Then the absolute mass, absolute charge, relative charge, regarding the characteristics and properties is given. That is also very important. table of this, which is the particle. If we talk about regarding the particle, if it's electron or proton and neutron. If we talk regarding the symbol, then symbol of electron is E, proton is P, and neutron is N. Coming to the next part, that is the next characteristic is nature. The nature of electron, you already know it is negatively charged. Coming to the proton, it is positively charged. And neutron, it is no charge. Next is, if we talk about the relative charge, that means in comparison, then this is minus 1, this is plus 1, and this is 0. Next is the absolute charge. Absolute charge on electron is minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Coming to the proton, it is plus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. Neutron, again it's 0. The next particular fact is regarding the relative mass of electron. Then proton and neutron are having suppose one charge, then electron is 1 upon 840 times heavier as compared to proton, and as compared to neutron 187, but approximately we are writing 184. Moving on, the next particular fact of this particular table, which is the absolute mass. Here it is 9 into 10 raised to minus 28 gram. Here it is 1.6 into 10 raised to approximately their weights are same. This is an approximation. So this is the characteristic of the three things, which is the proton, electron and neutron. So before we move further, please note down this content, then we'll move further. Quick. So I hope you have noted down this content. So after that you are having a concept which will be doing it in our next lecture. So I hope you are very clear with the content that has been done today. You have understood all the concepts that have been taught today. Friends, remember that it is very important for you to revise all the content because this content is such that at least some of the things which in between I'll be taking, but now we are having the whole chapter 4 at glance. So till now I think you're clear with the concept, and that's all for today's content. Thank you so much for listening to me, and have a very good day. And that's all. Okay, keep doing the homework, stay safe, bye bye, have a good day.